You released a statement last week in which you questioned why the U.S. would be taking the lead in an international crisis and that an international response makes more sense in this.
Certainly. I mean, when you talk about the use of chemical agents, you know, against civilians, that's not a U.S. Issue. That should be an international issue because there's the Geneva Convention of 1925 that outlaws the use of chemical agents in warfare.
Why do you think there's such reluctance internationally to even get involved with this with the United States?
Well, simply because they look at the Iraq situation, come to find out there was not weapons of mass destruction. Maybe after the UN survey report is released, we'll find that it was not the Assad regime that was responsible for the attack, but rather the local rebels. And I think it's also the concerns about retaliation, especially as far as oil goes, if you end up attacking Syria.
I know. Last week, Great Britain saying, no, we're not getting involved in this at all.
Exactly.
Now, the president, we've talked about seeking congressional approval for some type of military action against Syria. In the last half hour, we heard John Boehner say, I'm backing the president. Is this a good sign that he will get congressional approval, you think?
Yeah, it really is, because I think the president in the end will get congressional approval. I don't think the hurdle is going to be the Senate. I think it's going to be the House. And so to see Boehner, who heads up the Republican minority, saying that, I think is a good sign.
Now, you mentioned fear of retaliation, too. What are the ramifications in this country and globally, too, if the U.S. goes it alone in a military response?
Well, it's, you know, certainly you don't get that moral support that you would normally get, be it that the operation goes right or not, from the international community. There's also the possibility that Syria may turn to Iran, and Iran may decide to support them and cut back on oil production. Depending on how severe the actions are the United States takes, Assad may decide to take more military action in his own country. It could even spill over into countries like Turkey and Iraq.
Almost have a chain reaction effect in the Middle East.
Exactly. And some of those countries, like Iraq, are oil-producing countries.
Sure. How about Russia and China? How could U.S. action against Syria impact our relations with those two countries?
Well, right now, both those countries are not supporting the U.N. Resolution. Russia has already moved two warships into the Mediterranean Sea. And so the question is, are they just going to stand by, or if the United States decides to go forward, are they going to try to counteract anything that we end up doing? Russia is also an oil-producing country. Mm-hmm. They may decide, likewise, to drive up their prices as a retaliation against our action. And then there's always China. China is against it. China holds about $1 trillion worth of our debt. That could have some certainly economic implications for us. And we also need China's support as far as our dealings with North Korea, as far as their nuclear weapons program goes.
All right. Professor Kirill Ford, thanks for being with us and for your insight tonight. Good to see you.
Thank you.